This is the fifth day of striking out here at Granada Elementary. You know, we're tired. Luckily, we're not hungry. We have a lot of food that comes out here every day. It's a little colder today, but thank goodness, no rain. So we're all real happy about that. But it's getting tougher. You know, each day we go home at about after 4 o'clock, and we just sit on the couch. We can't even do anything else. It's more tiring than teaching, I'll tell you that. Well, as far as the negotiations, that they got back together yesterday, we don't hear much about it because this is a confidentiality issue. But the good news that we heard, at least, was that they were talking till midnight. So at least nobody walked out of the room, and they're still talking, and they're supposed to be working through the weekend. The Lopez family, oh my gosh. They are such a wonderful family. They have brought food. They're getting donations.
My wife has been doing all the footwork, making phone calls, contacting local vendors. You give them info?
Tamale House donated breakfast for the teachers this morning. Yesterday we had Mi Carbonero, the pupusa place. And the day before we had Panda Express from Granada Hills. And every day we, you know, we have great supporters, so we're very happy and grateful for that.
It's been great, you know, to see parents and teachers unite, you know, and go through this uphill battle, you know.
But one of the things that is just genuine is that they're here united as teachers and families, and I couldn't get a better school. I'm so happy to have my daughter in this school. Every day for me, it's a gift. I always tell the teacher that. Ms. Cabrera is our kinder teacher. And every time I see her, we say thank you to her because she's been doing so many things with my daughter. I need to let you know, my daughter came with special needs and she didn't speak, she wasn't talking. And when I brought her to this school, this is one of the things that I said, please, I need her to start emerging more with speech. In a month, my daughter was already doing leaps and bounds because of the teachers, you know, nurturing her pedagogy, her methodology is so on target, but she goes beyond that. And that's what my daughter needed.
We've always thought of ourselves as a family, and now we are fighting together. And, you know, it gets a little emotional. You know, we've actually become closer. So, you know, maybe there's even a positive side to what's happening is that we're getting to know each other even better and we're becoming stronger as a group. And we know, and I've been telling them, that as long as we're fighting together, we can do anything. On the internet, we started hearing about groups of schools that were going to go to one area together to make a big rally. They were sort of organic. They were not organized by UTLA. They were organized by the different schools that are close by. It goes on the internet, and more schools hear about it. And then we went to one that was right by our school at Balboa and San Fernando Mission. But it was a real empowering feeling to be out there in the rain. There were drummers out there, people were playing music, people were dancing, and just crossing the street round and round. And we're guessing there's probably 800 to 1,000 people out there. And it just empowers the area when you see and you find out what schools people are from, and you realize we're not just our little school here by ourselves in this little neighborhood. We're part of the bigger movement. We don't always see that every day.
So do you look at this strike as a social disaster?
Do I look at it as a social disaster? I see it as a miscommunication and understanding between a superintendent that wants to run the school but sees it as dollars and a business rather than education. And you have teachers that really and truly want to do the moral imperative of educating our future, our citizens that are going to be running the school, the schools, the hospitals, the colleges. And I know that when students come back to see their teachers' years, they always remember their teachers. And so I ask and implore the superintendent, please reflect on what you're doing and bring this to an end so that we could have our kids back in the classroom.
We are in it for the long haul. You know, both my wife and I are teachers. It's our only source of income. And, you know, we're out here as long as it takes. My dad was a teacher also for 39 years, and he was in the strike in 1970 when they formed UTLA. He was in the strike in 1989. And actually on Wednesday, he came out here and picketed with us Wednesday afternoon. So we're from a family that doesn't give up. We are stronger together, and we're gonna win this thing. We have to, for the kids.